Hi, I've bought a bigger electromagnet. Much bigger. It is obviously stronger than my smaller one, but not everything is as obvious as what meets the eye. While these two look the same, just in different sizes, they behave as opposites. As the name implies, an electromagnet requires electricity to be a magnet. This big one... What is going on? Be careful near strong magnets. Don't let them bite your fingers. 3 years ago, I made my first video about electromagnets. Being used to handle strong permanent magnets, it was refreshing and fun to play with a different magnet. The way you can turn an electromagnet off is so weird when you are used to being in trouble whenever something large gets stuck to a permanent neodymium magnet. But I wish I had a stronger, bigger electromagnet. So I decided to buy this monster. With a pull force of 1900 newtons, which can hold around 193 kilograms with the gravity at my place, it is close to 5 times stronger than my small one. However, rather counterintuitive, this electromagnet can hold close to 200 kilograms without using any electricity. It is magnetic when turned off, a permanent electromagnet. Measuring it at different points, it seems to be max 230 millitesla. With a bridge added to close the gap between the poles, it measures up to 330 millitesla or so. Not really impressive compared to a neodymium magnet of the same size. But I have not turned it on yet. What are these wires for? I can't find any instructions on how to use this electromagnet. Neither on the seller's nor the manufacturer's website. But there are some electrical clues. I bought it as a 12 volts, 45 watts electromagnet. Oddly enough, the exact same brand and model number is listed as 60 watts in other places. So is it 45 or 60 watts? Luckily, it is easy to determine for a DC electromagnet due to Ohm's and Watt's law. I just need to measure its DC resistance. 3.2 ohms would make it a 45 watts magnet at 12 volts DC. 2.4 ohms if it is a 60 watt magnet at the same voltage. My Fluke has a 0.1 ohm offset and measures the coil to 3.3 ohms after offset. Let's get a second opinion from the multimeter I tested against the smartphone earlier. It is slower than the Fluke, but has no offset. 3.2 ohms. Alright, safe to say this is a 45 watts version. Another clue is the color coding of the wires. On my first electromagnet, both wires are blue, indicating no recommended polarity. Plus from the power supply can be connected to either wire. It just changes the magnetic polarity of the electromagnet, as shown in the earlier video. On the bigger one, the wires are color-coded red and blue. Most likely red is for plus. Let's try with a relatively low 9 volts and see what happens to the magnet's strength. Plus to red wire. Oh, interesting. Sparks fly when disconnecting due to back EMF from the collapsing magnetic field inducing electricity in the coil. But more surprising, the magnet gets weaker when I power up the electromagnet with plus to the red wire. A reverse electromagnet. Let me mount the magnet and test this effect further. There we go. The permanent electromagnet is holding the 2.5 kg weight plate just fine, even though it is only touching the magnet at a small spot near the center. Will the magnet lose enough force from 9 volts to drop the weight? Nah, the weight just wiggles a bit. Easier to see from my angle of view. time to give the electromagnet the voltage it is designed for, I will limit my lab power supply to 12 volts. Aha! I am starting to see the point of this weird magnet. Unlike a common electromagnet, this one will not turn off during a power outage. And unlike a permanent magnet, it is still easy to remove large weights from this one just with a pulse of electricity. So easy and elegant compared to removing the weight from a permanent neodymium magnet. But is the magnet still magnetic after this drop? Yep, still on when turned off. How much electricity is needed to drop a 2.5 kilograms weight? Looks like around 7.6 volts and 2.4 amps. I thought the 9 volts battery could deliver that. I guess it has too much internal resistance. How about 1.25 kilograms? Can you guess if it requires less, the same, or more electricity? Around 8.7 volts and 2.7 amps. It took more, since the magnet had to be weakened even more to let gravity win. Makes me wonder if the advertised 12 volts 45 watts will make the magnet lose all of its magnetic field. We'll find out after this short message. A huge thank you to all my patrons. I appreciate your help with keeping these videos like this one coming. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link in the description. Thank you. Now time to get a little more scientific. I will measure its magnetism on the sensor at 250 milliamps intervals. This will take some time, since the electromagnet has a duty cycle of only 10% and max 30 seconds at a time. But through the magic of editing, this will feel fast to you. Will it reach 0 millitesla, where it is not a magnet anymore? I was so busy watching the amps that I didn't realize I had crossed the zero magnetism point before reaching the rated 45 watts. At the end, the center had even switched from being a strong north pole to a weak south pole. Alright, when I plot the readings in graphs, it is clear the decrease in magnetic strength is linear to both voltage and amps. Highly predictable behavior. Looks like the zero point, where the magnet is not a magnet and starts switching polarity, is around 3.4 amps and 11.4 volts. Let's verify it in real life. Yes, it is around 3.43 amps and 11.4 volts, or just 39 watts. I guess they made sure in the design that no more than the rated 45 watts is needed for any sample. For this one, 39 watts is enough. But how does this all work? There's surprisingly little info about these online. However, there must be a permanent ring magnet in the centerpiece, providing the magnetism when the magnet is unpowered. Considering this electromagnet's high temperature limit of 130 degrees C, the permanent magnet can't be a high-grade N52 neodymium type. perhaps a high temperature grade such as N45SH. Around this magnet sits a coil, an electromagnet. When sending a current through this, with plus to the red wire, the electromagnet forms a magnetic field with opposite polarity to the permanence. At just the right wattage, the two opposing magnetic fields cancel each other out. Clever design. Do you see the same opportunity as me? What if we swap the electrical polarity to the electromagnet? Shouldn't the two magnets team up then, combining to double the strength? Let's try. Starting with a 63 millitesla north pole on the center. Here comes the reverse current. Nice! 130 millitesla north pole on the center. The magnet did double its power. This might turn into my favorite magnet type to play around with. Its hybrid technology, being both a permanent and electromagnet, really has a lot of advantages in my opinion. Click like if you agree and did like this video. And let me know in the comments what else you would like to see me test with this magnet. Or if you know of a bigger one for sale. In any case, thanks for watching. Bye for now.